Hi, everyone. I'm Travis Guillory from Two Works For You, and here's your latest digital update. The Oklahoma Attorney General's Office is making it their top priority to investigate and stop coronavirus fraud. You can help by hanging up on robocalls, always fact-checking information that you read online, and never clicking on unknown links. And no matter what, never give out your bank information. If you do fall victim to identity theft or to fraud, be sure to inform law enforcement immediately. And the Oklahoma House and Senate have reached an agreement on a $7.7 billion spending plan for the upcoming fiscal year. Because of the revenue shortfall, the budget would cut most state agency budgets by about 4%. It also taps into the state's savings and temporarily diverts funding from pension plans and transportation to prevent any deeper cuts. And the University of Tulsa is telling employees who are right now working remotely that they will not be called back to campus until at least July 6th. In an email to staff, they say a decision on whether people will return in July could come by sometime in mid-June. Starting May 10th, the TU campus bookstore will reopen, of course, with social distancing guidelines. And getting a look at some of the numbers of coronavirus cases now in Oklahoma and across the country and the world. No one in Oklahoma has died from the virus for a second day in a row. That's good news. Going forward, only 72 more patients have tested positive for COVID-19, bringing the number of confirmed cases to 4,044. Meanwhile, the State Department of Health tells us that 2,600 Oklahomans have now recovered from COVID-19. And right now, there are more than 1 million cases in the U.S., along with over 3.5 million cases worldwide. And that's your latest digital update from Two Works For You. I'm Travis Guillory.